best way to characterize it would be to say that the relationship between everybody in the community, how they live every day, what they see, what they experience, is largely determined by the built environment. So normally the built environment is roads and any number of buildings and any number of different facilities. But the built environment often lacks the color, the shape, the form, the space that begins to distinguish particular areas from each other. So public art allows you to develop a different kind of message about the relationship between the built environment, human creativity, and everyday life.
We've been working in Richmond here in real estate development for just about 25 years. It's very important for us at AMPRI to be closely linked with the community and being part of the community that we're building.
Public art really is a collaborative process, and so every public art project, it's not about the artist working quietly in their studio and then bringing something to the site. Public artists really does have to engage the public. They have to talk to, you know, all the stakeholders. They have to talk to who's paying the bills. Is it the city? Is it the developer? It's such a big team of people that are behind every public art work.
Richmond's in a really unique situation in that there's so much development happening. And because of that development, it's helped to create a healthy economy for public art, not only in terms of funding, but also in terms of opportunities. But within that, there's also opportunities to really do things different. There's not only the finances to support it, there is a sort of collective will to let it happen. It's an amazing environment.
Partnerships are actually fundamental. So the idea is to build clusters that mutually inform each other and individual clusters that gain strength from the partners they choose to work with. And when you have a mix of different levels of expertise, different levels of experience, but also different disciplines, an integrated approach, a holistic approach, creates an extraordinary level of integrations. And all of those partnerships, both from the industry side, from the nonprofit side, from the city side, have always been productive.
One of the key drivers for Stantec's business model is we work with communities, whether it's landscape architecture, all these things. We are really working with communities and we're driven to build better communities.
Cameron shed some light on the educational environment for public art, and together we put together a plan to fund a course on public art education at Emily Carr University that would allow these students to sort of understand what all the stakeholders in this process are looking for and manage all those expectations to create the final outcome.
So he had a bigger vision of what he wanted to do, and then Cameron Cartier, who had this big vision as well with him, they made it happen.
The course came about from a need. There is a huge gap in the way that young artists or emerging artists can enter the field of public art.
We want to make as many partnerships as we can in the community, and it fits directly within our brand message, which is creativity is your greatest natural resource. Meaning, what better way to demonstrate that brand than partner with external people that are trying to do creative things?
What we're dealing with is an ecology of creativity, an ecology of sustainability, an ecology of urban life, and how you actually interface with that requires students to develop a very, very multidisciplinary relationship to what they're doing.
There was this opportunity to capture a group of individuals that don't normally come together or don't normally work together. It was actually this huge experiment.
Working in the public realm, it really is about understanding a project from multiple perspectives. You see this collaboration, it's a collaboration of municipal government, educational institutions, and private sector partners. For these students to come in and see all these different views, I think it gives them a very comprehensive idea of what it looks like to work collaboratively in the community.
So we're bringing really interesting people to the conversation, and it can't happen at all unless we have this collective will to make it happen.
So we bring these students together, we put a problem before them to solve that the community partner has offered us or asked us, and we answer it for them. And this is what we do best at Emily Carr.
Collaboration is one of the essential things in public art.
And we believe that public art is just one of those things that contribute to better neighborhoods, better communities, and I guess we're glad to kind of be part of that process.
There's nothing more exciting when you get people from different backgrounds in the same room discussing the same idea.
We realized that we were doing something really innovative here, and this is something that we really wanted to share with the world, and we want to build this model so that it can be replicable in other communities so that other developers, other municipalities, and other educational institutions can follow the blueprint of what we've put together here and create the same type of outcomes, the learning outcomes in their communities, and strengthen the pool of emerging artists in their community. And the ideal way to do this was to partner with Carey Communications, Shared Kare, and create a documentary for this initiative.
The documentation, the understanding of process, defines who we are and who we have been.
In the future, they'll have a better sense of the broad scope of things that they need to bring to the table.
If we don't take the responsibility of bringing the next generation forward, we're doing a great disservice to the entire society.
We're almost through the course. It's been documented on a week-by-week basis, and we're really excited to show the rest of the world what we're working on here in Richmond.
So the question of how you partner, it's not something you can predetermine fully. You just have to have the willingness to engage in the discussion. And once you actually engage in it, and I think that would be the experience of many students here, as well as faculty, you discover a lot more than you ever thought you would.